Welcome to the African Album Review Podcast, where we review Africa's best and latest music projects.
Africa, Morise. My name is MJ Omoto and I welcome you to the African Album Review Podcast. Thank you so much for joining me on the podcast today. Hopefully everybody's doing good. Me, I'm doing good. Can't complain. Ish, guys, November is moving quick. Anyway, today, guess what? It's Nigeria again. I promise this might be the last one from Nigeria for a while, but let's get to it.
The latest African album review is...
True to my current form, I had no clue Davido had an album coming out until yesterday or something. Great, isn't it? Now, here's the crazier thing. I haven't done a Davido review before. I was meant to review his album from late last year, but life happened and that's a story for another day. So, here is a review for Davido's new album titled A Better Time. A Better Time was released November 12th under DWE, and that's exclusive license to Sony Music. It's got 17 songs, 54-minute, 50-second runtime, 12 features, multiple producer placements, including Kidominant, Fresh VDM was under Davido's label, Benjamin Idoko, Napji, Semzi, Mastodon, and more. The album cover sees Davido holding, I think it's his kid, has to be his kid, and it's got the black and white going on. Very nice cover, nice and simple, but quite symbolic. And hey, if you do like what we do here, do go to the website motomotomusic.com. Top right hand corner, there's a PayPal icon. Click it and donate something. $1,000, $2,000, whatever you can to keep us going. And we appreciate it. Thanks.
Album review.
Let's analyze the music.
The album opens up with a pacey FEM or FEM, I think that's what you call it, where you get vintage Davido with that vocal raspiness and some catchy melodies that are so sing-along. I caught myself singing along in no time, and that's when you know Davido is not playing games, because when he does that, he catches you hook, line, and sinker. The song Joel, to me, is a close cousin to huge hits such as Fall and If, with that light pom-pom sound that is all too familiar. When you listen to Davido telling this girl, he's like, yo, look into my eyes. You know this song isn't one to mess with. That's a cue, bro. That is a cue. If you know, you know. I reckon this one will be an easy pick for many of his existing fans that they will readily appreciate and catapult to hit status. In some weird twisted way, it made me think of a play on Wizkid's Joro, just the title. Joro, you know what I'm saying? But I'm not trying to start something here. It's just what came to mind when I saw the title. Otherwise, there's nothing relating the two. The song Holy Ground with Nicki Minaj was a surprise, mostly because the queen decided to really embrace Afrobeats and flow to it rather than dictate how it should go just because she's the world-class talent she is. Such as Nicki Minaj's versatility, she could study a genre and kill it anytime. And she delivered by singing well as rapping impeccably as usual. I can't say the song is necessarily my favorite from this project, but I think it has the potential to grow on me, so I'll give it a few days. Another high-profile collab, so Davido team up with Young Thug and Chris Brown on Shopping Spree. That song is a sex song, trust me. The kind of song you put in the background while the mood has been set and you're all about to knock some boots. The deep bass on there is quite legendary, and the three artists really complement each other on this track, so I hope, you know, they'll give us something else down the line. Tanana featuring Tiwa Savage is the perfect tempo, and by golly, Tiwa Savage did the damn thing. Ooh. Think Afrobeats laced with a beautiful island sprinkle at a beach party with people just enjoying the summer vibes. Davido tells Tiwa that he wants some Tanana. And I have no clue what Tanana is, but I reckon it's for adults. Davido mixed things up with housey numbers such as Heaven, which has some Amapiano-esque elements to it, making a wonderful Afrofusion. The same can be said for La La featuring CK, which is sumptuous to say the least. You know that smart house music where the beat is not overcooked while exhibiting a maturity in the instrument selection, with a tasteful saxophone there, you know, some honey sweet keys, and a lovely guitar just to top it off. Man, this song is good. It's real, real good. And speaking of Amapiano, I Got a Friend featuring Mea Kun and Shoma Josie is just that, Amapiano. It has a dangerously bouncy beat with Mea Kun adding a sweet vocal to Shoma Josie's playful and fun delivery. And this continues the highly evident love affair between Nigerian musicians and South African beats that we've seen of late. Something Fishy is another song, and this one is in my head for the guitar strings. The guitar strings on that song deserve a special mention on their own, so I just thought I would let you know. So watch out for that when you listen to this song.
Album review.
The technical side of things.
On the technical side, honestly, when I think of the genres or the theme, at least the themes on A Better Time by Davido, you will find that it's true to Davido form. Most of it is really love and relationships more than anything else. And obviously he talks about the money here and there. But what makes Davido a unique songwriter is not depth in the words per se. It's the simplicity that is easy to relate to for anybody. His lyrics are so easy to relate to. This is not a weakness, it's intentional and goes with his delivery as a performer. This is why it is a formula that works. The voice works for the content. That flies under the radar for many listeners, but because Davido does it so effortlessly, you can believe that he would definitely say something that corny and make a girl smile while at it and get the girl still. I highly respect how he has made that his own sort of thing. And, you know, it might be a small thing, but I think it's not easy to do at all. Something Davido doesn't readily get props for, other than the simplistic songwriting, which is actually quite clever, is what I like to call ad-lib singing. He finds a way to come up with short lines that he accentuates with ad-lib-like singing, and also backing vocals to make larger verses and tell coherent stories. Where many other artists would make up lyrics in longer form before filling in the ad-libs as an afterthought, he does it so uniquely, and it's just one big mashup which just sounds amazing. The technical aspects of A Better Time will likely go underappreciated in many circles, but that's only because Davido has been on this high standard for more than 4 years. He hasn't missed a step for a long, 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 long time, and is working at the highest levels of the industry. The mixing and mastering are just another level altogether. No other comments from me on this. In the sequencing, there are some interesting points to note. Davido started the album purely by himself from track 1 to track 3, and I see that as a way to solidify his own status before dropping some major, major collaborations like the one with Nicki Minaj, which is track 4 on here. The high-profile international collabos also took different forms. The Nicki Minaj one being very Afro beats, so he basically, you know, put Nicki Minaj on his own type of record. While the Chris Brown and Young Thug one was more R&B dancehall fusion, and at the same time, the Nas and Hit Boy song is a hip-hop R&B number. And then finally, the Lil Baby track, taking on more of a dancehall pop fusion somewhat. That is a great show of adaptability, and he tried to challenge each artist on something unique, because you know Davido gives something no one else they've worked with does, and it was nice to see the other artists actually step up to the plate.
Album review.
The final thoughts.
I wouldn't classify A Better Time as a no skips project, but at 17 tracks, that's allowed. It's understandable. 17 tracks, come on. It has enough for everyone to pick something they love about it. To me, this is a label-influenced type of project that has a formula meant to maximize on all possible aspects of Davido's star. It's not an album designed to challenge what we know about him as an artist, but rather take advantage of that knowledge and, well, milk it. From great collabos to predictable and guaranteed hits to pleasantly surprising numbers, you get everything with A Better Time. Davido does well to balance things out with some nicely picked African collabos that include the best of the best, such as Tiwa Savage, Moogies, Saudi Soul from Kenya, Bella Shmurda, Mea Kun, CK, and Shoma Josie from South Africa. As a result, Davido gave two versions of himself here. The Davido we all know and love, and that can nice up any Afrobeats song with ease. And just those, you know, simple lyrics that are so catchy with the one-liner that you keep on singing over and over again. And he just does well with just making melodies to that. He also gave us the experimental Davido, looking to do more in the US market, especially by trying different genres and securing absolutely top collabos. In a nutshell, this becomes a mixed pop album, maybe Afropop, a mixed Afropop album that is not really genre specific, but tests the limit of Davido's own fans in accepting him, trying new things, but appeasing them by giving them enough of what's expected. My songs of the album are Joe, Maybe featuring Moogies, Heaven, Danana featuring Tiwa Savage, that's a jam, man. Shopping Spree with Chris Brown and Young Thug, I Got a Friend, I think that's the one that features Shoma Josie and Mea Kun, Sunlight, Femme, and The Best, again featuring Mea Kun. Yeah. You can find A Better Time by Davido pretty much anywhere online. It's going viral right now, which is expected. I mean, it's Davido. Give it a try. I think any Afrobeats lover will find something amazing on here just to, you know, enjoy. On the other hand, I think this one is also suited to a bit of the American side of things, with the collabos with Chris Brown and Young Thug. I think those types of songs could become a problem if taken up by the right crowd. So yeah, give it a try. A Better Time by Davido. Otherwise, that's it for me. My name is MJ Omoto, son of Zimbabwe, signing out. Peace. Dende.
Moto Moto Music, the best place to listen to podcasts about African music online.